Hello everyone, dear students, in this video we are going to learn about the Roman numerals. So, have you ever noticed these symbols? What do these symbols represent and how they are different from numbers we use? Well, these are Roman numerals. The Roman used 7 English alphabet to represent number. These alphabets are I used for 1, V used for 5, X used for 10, L used for 50, C used for 100, D used for 500, M used for 1000. So students, these are 7 English alphabet to represent numbers. In the Roman numerals, there is no symbol for 0 and there is no concept of place value system. All the numbers are written by different combination of these symbols. So, forming the Roman numerals, there are some important rules. So, let's discuss with the first rule of Roman numerals.
Rule 1. Repetition of numerals means addition. For example, I. So we all know that I using for 1, so it means 1 plus 1 equals to 2. After that, I, which is equal to 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is equal to 3. Then X we are using for 10, then 10 plus 10 equals to 20. Then X, which is equal to 10 plus 10 plus 10 equals to 30. Dear students, according to rule first, please note down the two important point. First is only I, X, C, M can be repeated. Means hum sirf I, X, C aur M ko repeat kar sakte hain. V, L, D cannot be repeated. Isme V, L, D repeat nahi honge. Okay. Second is no symbols can be repeated more than 3 times. It means जो भी आपके पास symbol है 7 letter symbols, it means वो more than 3 times आपके use नहीं हो सकते हैं. Okay, only 3 times you can use these symbols. Now next is rule number 2. Smaller numeral written after larger numeral means addition. It means students, अगर हम smaller numeral को after larger numeral लिखते हैं, then we have to do the addition in that case. For example, VI. Here, V used for 5 and I used for 1. So, I is the right side of V. It means 5 plus 1 equals to 6. Same case in the VII. And next is XI. Here, X used for 10 and I used for 1. So, it means 10 plus 1 equals to 11. Students, let's take few more examples to understand the rule number 2. First is LX. L equals to 50 and X using for 10. So it means 50 plus 10 equals to 60. After that, LXX. Again, L equals to 50 and X equals to 10. Then 50 plus 10 plus 10 equals to 70. That is rule 2, which means smaller numerals written after larger numeral means addition. Next is rule 3. According to this rule, smaller numeral written before a larger numeral means subtraction. It means students, if we write smaller numeral before the larger numerals, then we have to do the subtraction in that case. For example, I, V. Here again, I equals to 1 and V equals to 5. But here, I before the V. It means we have to do the subtraction. So, 5 minus 1 equals to 4. Same in IX. Again, I is equal to 1 and X equals to 10. So, 10 minus 1 equals to 9. Students, let's take the few more example of rule number 3. First example is XL. Here, L used for 50 and X used for 10. So 50 minus 10 equals to 40. Next example is XC. Here C used for 100 and X used for 10, which is equal to 100 minus 10 equals to 90. Students, few points using to need consider this rule number 3. First is V, L, D are never subtracted, which means we cannot write Vx, which is equal to 10 minus 5 equals to 5. Second is I can be subtracted from V and X only. And next is X can be subtracted from L and C only. So students, this is all about rule number 3.
So students, after the discussion of rule, let's take some example. First is 29. So first 29 you can write 20 plus 9, and Roman number for 20 is XX and for 9 is IX. Then your Roman numeral from 29 is XXIX. Next is 49. 49 you can write 40 plus 9. Okay. And Roman numeral for 40 is XL. Okay. And for 9 is IX. Then for 49 is XLIX. And then another example is 92. It is 90 plus 2, and Roman numeral for 90 is XC and 2II. So it means XCII. So students, you can solve another example of Roman numerals. So students, after the discussion of rules of Roman numerals, I hope you all will be able to write the Roman numerals. Thank you.